He's tall 175 meters and he weighs around 68 kilos. Long time representative of the national team of Russia in karate Kyokushin. Gold and bronze medal in the European Championship of Kyokushin and a world title in the juvenile division. Along me commentating will be the national coach of the Bulgarian national kickboxing team, Mr. Krasimir Kolev. How are you, Mr. Kolev? What are your predictions for the next 12 fights?
Oh, it will be very hard fights, it will be very interesting. So I think that all the audience will enjoy it. There's a mixed styles. We have Muay Thai, we have K1, we have full contact Kyokushin. It will be very interesting.
Okay, in the first bout we're going to see Mr. Petar Stoykov, who is multiple time champion of Bulgaria of kickbox. What are your impressions from this guy?
This guy, he's very, very fast. He work a lot of combination. So I think that if he make a good tactics, he can beat the Russian fighter. But Magomedov, everybody know the Russians are very, very strong. And I think that Omar Magomedov will use very strong kicks, very fast kicks, so this will be his weapon.
Okay, now we're seeing Omar Magomedov walking into the ring. He seems really confident, really full of adrenaline and ready to go to war. I can't wait for the beginning of this fight. Only 23 years of age, the born in Moscow fighter, he's coming here to Bulgaria to prove himself against one of the best fighters of Bulgaria in the lightweight division.
Позабави се малко, подържани в напрежение, но въпреки всичко е тук. Послушахме неговата нежна музика, надявам се ударите да не бъдат нежни. Срещу него в синия край за победа излиза българският
боец Петър Стойков. We might hear the crowd roar here. The Bulgarian Petar Stoykov. We hear really loud here. Cheer crowd. Traditional Bulgarian music for the walkout of Mr. Petar Stoykov. Wow, that sure will give goosebumps to most of the fights here. He's got quite a resume, we gotta say that again. Multiple times champion of Bulgarian kickboxing karate Kyokushin, European and world title in Muay Thai. Silver medalist of the World Championships of Karate Kyokushin, and he is a juvenile champion World Karate Kyokushin.
Петър Стойков своето място в синият ъгъл на ринга. Нека ви представя двамата състезатели. Червения ъгъл. 23 годишният Омар Магомедов, майстор на спорта в Русия.
International Professional League. Three rounds of 3 minutes.
Световното първенство през 2013 година. Любопитен факт за него е, че е ставал шампион на панкратион на Русия. Това е един древен спорт.
Omar Magomedov is a pankration champion, which is the original sport from which MMA has arrived. So he is quite a diverse fight and with a lot of background, just like Petar Stoykov.
Той е настоящ световен шампион по Muay Thai, бил е и европейски шампион, както и многократен републикански първенец по карате, кьокушин и кикбокс. Сребърен медалист на световно първенство по кьокушин за юноши старша възраст, състезател на клуб Самурай Бургас, но подготовката си направи в спортен клуб Армеец. Търпелив стратег, един от опитните ни състезатели. Надяваме се, разбира се, да направят добър двубой. Няма като Левски ЦСК да има равни тук, ще има победители задължително. Рефер на срещата е Захари Дамянов.
Захари Дамянов, Сенсей Захари Дамянов, which is the one of the most decorated Kyokushin fighters of Bulgaria. Four-time European champion, All-American on All-Japan champion, will be the referee of this bout. Fighter square up now. Oops, it's a bit hard to pull that gi off the glove. Last preparations before the start of the fight. Mario Dimitrov, head coach of Sports Club Armets and coach of Petar Stoykov, tying up his fighter's belt. And here we go. Mr. Kolev, do you think the fact that Magomedov is actually a southpaw will be kind of difficult for Stoykov?
No, I think that the coach of Petar is made
good strategy
for southpaw. So I think I see in his corner, in Petar's corner, is Christian Kurunchev, European and world champion in Vako. He's also southpaw, so Petar is prepared for this southpaw.
Okay. Oh wow! Now we see a nice. That shouldn't be called a knockdown, right?
No, it's just a
trip.
Yeah, it's a trip.
Okay, now Stoykov is pushed to the ropes. Will he see him getting into the center of the ringer and holding the center of the ring? Or he will be the counter-attacking fighter?
No, I think that he will start attacking. Just to check his opponent, the first round, he start fight easy. And I think that at the end of the first round...
Oh, now he tried knee to the head. However, Magomedov shows pretty good defense so far.
Yeah. Petar is trying to get too close and is not good. He have to use his hands. He should do good boxing.
I haven't seen him use much wall kicks at this point. Do you think he should start using them more?
Yeah, he should use his legs. He's a complex fighter, so he have to use all his weapons.
Yeah, maybe he can set up some head kicks or mid kicks, even get a knockout if he starts implementing the low kicks more and more.
Yeah, we see the Russian fighter. He's doing well on the ring, moving from side to side. This is the way that makes Petar difficult to attack.
He shows good combinations with his kicks and really good front kicks. As soon as Stoykov tries to get close to him, he fires a nice front kick. A second time Stoykov tries this back fist. Doesn't seem like a good strategy to me.
Yeah, he wastes a lot of energy.
30 seconds left in this round. Pretty close round. What do you think the judge's decision will be for that round?
Maybe draw or with a little bit for Omar.
Okay. I wouldn't want to be on their place, that's for sure.
Yeah. It's a hard style.
Very, very good round. Yeah, non-stop action.
I see that Omar hands in middle of the station, in middle range, is at a wall. I think that Petar can use this mistake.
Yep. So Mr. Stoykov is actually Muay Thai and kickboxing champion, like he said. Maybe he's used to using his elbows.
In this fight,
and if there were elbows in a close distance, maybe he could have got the best.
Yeah, he can use it. I don't know why he don't use it.
Yep. So the rules actually allow him to use elbows.
Yeah.
In this rule set, okay, that's great. He should start using them more in the second round in such case.
You see some good knees
in
the body.
Yeah, knees are really good. Yeah. But I think Omar Magomedov is so well prepared. I mean, Russian fighters. They go through hell in their training camps, and I'm sure that his body is really strong as steel.
Yeah. They don't have problems with condition.
Second round. Let's see what's up. Stoykov gets the center of the ring. Will he be the aggressor in this second round?
This is the way that he have to fight to win.
Oh, that's a nice knee.
Now he tried a nice, what's that called? Ushiro, Ushiro Geri or Ushiro?
Yeah, Vash? Spinning back kick.
Yeah, to deliver. Oh, that spinning back fist was oh, so close.
Yeah, and after that he, yeah, and after that the Russian makes a hook.
Oh, that was a great takedown from Badilak. Unfortunately, that doesn't give him any points. However, it surely tires up his opponent.
Yeah. You know that the Russian fighter, he used to fight in Pankration, so this is normal for him.
Yeah, he's familiar with grappling for sure. However, yeah. Whoa, Petar Stoykov, I think he rocked him.
That was very nice knee.
Good knee to the chin.
And very good combinations.
Yeah. He's got to push the pace nice. He can knock him out right now.
Of course, he has to do boxing. The Russian fighter cannot see boxing.
He seems pretty tired, Omar Magomedov.
Yeah.
I think that's because of the punishment he took. Oh, now a nice left hook.
Yeah, this is.
Oh, now he's firing back. What a heart he shows.
Very hard fight. Very good fight. I think that Petar is also a bit of tired. After this combination, he has to slow down.
Yeah, and there are a minute and 20 seconds left in round two. Somebody is going down, that's what I see.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, now Omar Magomedov is trying desperately to get to the clinch. Yeah, that those are signs of
tiredness,
that he's getting tired. And oh, the finish
nice
might
right
be really
hand.
Close.
Have to use his right hand with straights and uppercuts. Yeah, we heard that,
oh, that was a great combination. He tried it in round one, but now it worked better for him. I think that even if Stoykov is hurt, he wouldn't show it. He would cover it with poker face.
Yeah, both fighters in some moment was hurt and they didn't show it. I heard Petar's coach that they told him right hand, to use his right hand. This is the right strategy for down.
Oh, that was
very
a great,
nice.
Finally, at the third try, the spinning
maybe
back
fourth,
fist landed. What a round. Non-stop action. Both fighters got rocked at some point.
See?
Now in round three, it's about who has better conditioning and who can show more heart than the other.
Yeah, I think that Petar goes up with
and final round. So close fight. I don't know who's gonna be the winner. Maybe the third one's going to declare the winner. Another takedown from Omar Magomedov. However, he's not doing much except tiring himself with those takedowns. Petar Stoykov is using more simple and classic combination with his boxing. Pretty good defense from Omar Magomedov since the beginning of round three. He's not giving anything to Stoykov.
Yeah, he's trying to move, to be out of range. And kick fast and go out.
Oh,
see,
nice left hook, yeah. Yeah, these guys that are under 70 kilos, They're both fast and at the same time really strong, because the lighter divisions are not so strong and the heavier divisions are not so light on their feet. However, those guys got it all. And they got like an infinite gas tank. So far we have seen non-stop actions. I'm wondering how many shots have been thrown during the fight. Now a good knee from Stoykov. The crowd's gotta support him. I bet that he's feeling really motivated to get the win in front of home crowd here in Sofia, Bulgaria. The second edition of SENSHI, the newest K1 Muay Thai and Kyokushin organization in Bulgaria. Nice front kick from Stoykov. Oh, and now a good front kick from Magomedov to the face.
Petar showing some tiredness. I think
1 minute left.
Yeah, the last minute is the most important minute of the fight. They show everything that they have.
Omar is getting his low hands low at some points of the fight.
Yeah, both are tired.
Oops, now they try a wrestling stunt, throwing your opponent out of the ring. Now they go to a full out bro, and another takedown from Omar Magomedov. Maybe he should test himself in Sambo sometime.
For sure, these takedowns get tired, both of them.
However, they wouldn't contribute to the referee's decision, right?
Yeah. Yes, but if it's draw, this makes sense of the judges.
What a fight for the second edition of SENSHI here. The opening fight, two great young fighters showing warrior's heart. Wow, I don't want to be on the referee's seat right now. A pretty close fight. How do you see it, Mr. Kolev?
First round for the Magomedov, second round for sure for Petar, and third round, I don't know, I can give it draw, and I don't know what exactly the judges will give.
Yeah, so it's a matter of seconds before we understand what's the decision of the judges.
I will see the decision.
The first fighter will be awarded by the head secretary of the Kyokushin World Union, Sensei Alexander Pichkunov.
Захари Дамяров току-що ми съобщи, че с 3-0 съдийски гласа победител е Петър Стойков от България.
With unanimous decision, Petar Stoykov gets the win here in Armeyets Arena in the first fight of the second edition of the newest K1 and Muay Thai organization here in Bulgaria. Good job by both fighters. However, Stoykov showed a little bit of better technique and a better conditioning than his opponent. Petar Stoykov is getting applauded by the fans here in Armeyets Arena in Sofia.
You see out of the ring, Magomedov is really, really tired. Yeah, he cannot stand on his feet.
Yeah, and he's really, really disappointed that he didn't get the double.
He even cannot stand.
Oh, now we see a large cup that's going to be handed to the winner of this fight. Looks like the old days K1 dream cups that they used to give for the champions there, huh?
Yeah, maybe they're bigger.
Yeah, pretty good job from the organizers of this event. Actually, the winner of this fight, Mr. Petar Stoykov, will be awarded by Mr. Shihan Asen Asenov, who is part of the
Bulgarian Kyokushin Federation, the first gold medalist from the European Championships for Bulgaria. A man who has practiced Kyokushin for over 40 years now. So the old school meets the new school now.
Yeah, he's one of the iconic Kyokushin fighters in Bulgaria. And he's one of the most, the best trainers in Kyokushin in Bulgaria.
Oh yeah, he has produced many, many champions.
Yeah, world and European champions.
Christian Kolunchev, who is actually the European WAKO Pro champion.
Intercontinental champion
of WAKO Pro. He won his title in the first edition of SENSHI in Varna, Bulgaria, against Bojan Todorovic from Serbia in a five-round hard battle.